Insects have long been used as pest control over other insects, and the use of beneficial insects is gaining a lot of popularity in our gardens today instead of using chemicals. And Jessica Wallister is here today to give me some of the finer points on which bugs to use. Hi, Jessica.
How are you?
Thank you for coming.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.
And thank you for bringing all your friends. Now, you've written a book which I think is really interesting, and that's called Good Bug, Bad Bug.
Right, and bugs kind of have a bad reputation in the garden, and it's not deserved. We see a bug and we get in a panic and we run to the garage
right,
and we grab something to spray and we nuke the whole garden just in case. Well, gardeners are really surprised to find out that it's actually less than 10% of the insects that we find in our garden that are harmful.
All right,
remaining 90%?
Are
benign or beneficial.
But why don't you introduce us to and go through some of the different ones here, because now these I recognize.
Yeah, these are the cover girl.
Right,
ladybug. So to speak, ladybugs. Ladybugs are actually very voracious predators, both as the adult stage and their larval stage. And they prey upon all kinds of soft-bodied insects in our yards and gardens.
So soft-bodied are aphids and
mealybugs. Scales, young caterpillar eggs, which a lot of people are surprised to find out about. Many beneficial insects will actually prey upon different life stages of pests. So whether it's eggs or larvae or the pupa, different insects attack at different stages.
And Jessica, you can send away for these too, can't you? They come in the mail.
Yeah, you can mail order them from, there's assorted insectaries across the country that you can get them from. But actually, I consider it to be more important to use some methods to naturally boost your indigenous population because there's no guarantee when you buy ladybugs and release them in the garden that they're going to stick around.
Right, so you might as well do things to keep them there and get a nice balance in your garden.
Exactly.
Now, what are some of these other ones? What are these? Because they look like ladybugs, but they're smaller.
Yeah, this is actually a mealybug destroyer. They are in the
mealybug destroyer.
So these would be great for your greenhouse.
They would be. We have a lot of mealybugs.
Well, you have a lot of mealybugs, so this would be one to release in there. And these are scale destroyers.
Really?
And these are a member of the ladybug family, and these would be released again in a greenhouse.
And now what about in here? Now, there's an insect that everybody's pretty familiar with, the praying mantis in here.
Praying mantis, and we have some egg cases as well. These are what the praying mantis egg cases look like. What you need to know about praying mantis, though, is that they'll eat a good insect. They'll eat a ladybug or a bumblebee quickly as they'll eat a Colorado potato beetle.
Right.
But they're considered to be a beneficial. And same thing with spiders.
Now, we've got a great spider here. Now, this is a garden spider, right?
Mm-hmm. This is a
garden spider.
I
recognize this. These around here you see in the fall.
Yeah, usually late summer.
Late summer, they really come out. You can notice they have those bright yellow patterns on them.
Now, ground-dwelling spiders, this is a garden spider, so this is a web spinner, but like wolf spiders, which are the brown, hairy spiders that you find on the ground, right? They don't spin webs. When we talk about a pest control of spraying aphids off of a plant with a sharp stream of water, you think, they're just going to crawl right back up onto the plant, right? It's actually spiders, minute pirate bugs, big-eyed bugs, and other beneficials that will consume them on the ground level or very low in that plant before they have a chance to crawl back up and damage the plant.
Now, how do we go about figuring out which bugs are which? Like this. I mean, if I see this in my garden, I know that something's doing this.
Right.
Something's eating my plants.
Yeah, actually, as far as pests go, in a lot of situations, their damage is more recognizable than the pest itself. So learning to recognize very distinctive damage patterns is going to be easier than finding the pest. So you pick up this hibiscus leaf, and I can tell you it's sawfly larva. Because the damage is so distinctive, because it's on this particular species of plant.
And once you identify the insect, you can then go about releasing beneficial insects to take care of that insect.
Exactly. Releasing them or even companion planting for them. So when we talk about roses and how vulnerable they are to aphid damage, one of the greatest things that you can do to help control those aphids is to underplant your roses with a plant like Sweet Alyssum, which is very attractive to a species of parasitic wasp that preys upon those aphids.
Oh.
So you companion plant like that.
That's a great
tip. Get those. And you can also buy parasitic wasp eggs. And that's what these little cards are. And these are actually have moth eggs on them. And then the moth eggs have been parasitized by the parasitic wasp. The parasitic wasps will hatch out and will go on to make future generations. And so you basically kind of tear these tabs off.
And place them around?
And hang them in the plants with aphid problems.
Okay, so Jessica, what is this piece of cardboard with the screen over it?
This is actually the larva of lacewing.
And how would you introduce those to the garden?
Well, they're actually introduced by simply peeling back this layer and lay the corrugated cardboard in the garden, and they kind of climb
out on their own
and go do their stuff. Yeah.
Well, Jessica, this is really fascinating. I think it's a topic that most people are just getting to learn a little bit more about, and once they do, they're going to find that having beneficial insects in your garden is about the best thing you can do for your plants. Thank you very much.
It's been my pleasure.